In this video, we will demonstrate how to isolate pigments from spinach. You will need frozen spinach, magnesium sulfate, sand, and a mortar and pestle. Weigh about 3 grams of frozen spinach and 3 grams of magnesium sulfate. Add the spinach, magnesium sulfate, and a pinch of sand to the mortar, and crush the mixture for about 5 minutes using the pestle. Make sure to wear gloves and work inside the fume hood. You will also need 5 milliliters of acetone, 4 milliliters of petroleum ether, and 1 milliliter of water. Next, weigh about 3 grams of the spinach mixture and carefully add it to a small test tube. You can use a spatula or make a funnel from the weighing paper. Add 5 milliliters of acetone to the test tube and stopper with a silicone stopper. Shake for 5 minutes. Be sure to hold your thumb over the stopper so that it can't pop out. Remove the stopper occasionally to remove pressure inside the test tube. Use a pipette to transfer as much of the liquid as possible into a clean, small test tube. The pigments will be in the acetone. Add 4 milliliters of petroleum ether to the new test tube. Stopper and shake for a minute. Then add 1 milliliter of water, stopper, and shake for another minute. The stopper tends to pop out at this step, so hold it tightly with your thumb while shaking, and occasionally remove the stopper to release pressure. Next, centrifuge for about 1 minute to separate the layers. Remember to balance the centrifuge with another test tube of equal mass or volume opposite of your test tube. After the centrifuge stops completely, carefully remove your test tube. You should see the layers leaving the petroleum ether and the pigments on the top layer. In part 2, we will demonstrate how to set up a drying column. You will need sand, a pipette, sodium sulfate, cotton, and a ring stand. Place a small piece of cotton at the end of the pipette. Use a paper clip to push it to the bottom. Next, add about 1/4 inch of sand. Make sure to keep the sand level, followed by 1 inch of sodium sulfate. Put a small test tube under the drying column. Carefully pipette the green petroleum ether layer into the top of the drying column and let it run through the sodium sulfate into the collection tube. Cover the collection tube with parafilm and leave it in your drawer over the weekend to dry. In part 3, we'll be separating the pigments using column chromatography. You will need sand, about 5 milliliters each of ethanol, petroleum ether, 70-30 petroleum ether, and about 3 milliliters alumina, as well as the dried pigment from part 2. You will need to rehydrate your pigment using about 0.5 milliliters of petroleum ether. Prepare the column using a funnel, chromatography column, and stopcock from the microscale kit. Transfer the alumina into a flask. Add petroleum ether and mix. In order to successfully prepare your alumina in the column, pour it into the column while mixing so the solid does not settle to the bottom of the flask. Lightly tap the column with a pencil to help the alumina settle and avoid cracking. If the collection is slow, you can pipette the excess petroleum ether from the column to be reused to mix the alumina in the flask. Be careful not to pipette the settled alumina. Repeat this process until there is about 1 inch of alumina. Add 1/4 inch of sand to the column as in part 2, making sure the sand is level. Once the remaining petroleum ether is nearly absorbed into the sand, add 1/2 of the green pigment to the column. Make sure the column does not get dry. Once the green solution has seeped into the alumina, add more petroleum ether. If the yellow band begins to separate from the green band, continue to add petroleum ether until the yellow band gets near the bottom of the column, and then collect it in test tube 2. If the yellow band does not separate from the green band, then change to a more polar solvent, such as the 70-30 petroleum ether, until the yellow band passes through the column. After you have collected the yellow pigment, switch to test tube 3 to collect the intermediate between the green and yellow pigment until you can see the green band moving down the column. Here you can see our green band is moving down. Once the green band is almost at the bottom, switch to test tube 4 to collect the green pigment. If the green band does not begin to move, change to the more polar solvent ethanol. We'd add ethanol to move the green band down. Here we can see that the green is moving towards the bottom of the column. We switch collection tubes to collect the green pigment. Here you can see our four fractions. Test tube 1 has the petroleum ether, which is colorless. Test tube 2 has our yellow pigment. The intermediate is test tube 3. You can see it is between the yellow and the green color. And test tube 4 showing the green pigment. Test tube 2 and 4 would be used in the following TLC lab, which is not covered in this video.